He was elected president 1 year ago tonight, but was President Trump also on the ballot again last night? We wanted to take a moment to step back and take a look at the governor's race in battleground Virginia and how the Democrat Ralph Northam beat Republican Ed Gillespie in one of the first indications of how voters might be reacting to Mr. Trump's presidency so far. Now, Gillespie, the Republican, he chose a strategy of trying to thread a needle. He distanced himself personally from President Trump, with whom he never personally appeared, but he accepted the president's support on Twitter and in 11th-hour robocalls, and he campaigned with Vice President Pence, and he pursued a TV ad campaign that embraced many of the president's positions on issues such as immigration and Confederate statues in an apparent attempt to win over the Trump base and get them to the voting booths, running ads like this one.
MS-13 is a menace. Yet Ralph Northam voted in favor of sanctuary cities that let dangerous illegal immigrants back on the street, increasing the threat of MS-13.
I want to keep our statues up. Our history is our history, and we need to teach it, not erase it.
Now, before Election Day, before yesterday, Trump strategist Steve Bannon said, quote, "I think the big lesson for Tuesday is that, in Gillespie's case, Trumpism without Trump can show the way forward. If that's the case, Democrats better be very, very worried." It was Gillespie's embrace of President Trump's agenda and his talking points that made the race close, Bannon said. Of course, the race did not really actually end up being close, as most polling suggested it would be. Gillespie lost by almost 9 percentage points. Now, when Gillespie ran for Senate in 2014, he only lost by 0.8%. President Trump quickly took to Twitter last night to disown Gillespie entirely, saying, quote, "Ed Gillespie worked hard but did not embrace me or what I stand for." But many conservatives interpreted last night's election as a referendum on President Trump. Take a listen to Republican Congressman Scott Taylor of Virginia on CNN this morning.
I think that last night was a referendum. I don't think there's any way that you can look at it in a different way, to be honest with you, and be intellectually consistent.
So we took a look at the numbers, and here's the thing. Gillespie actually did get his voters to the polls. In those deep red parts of Virginia, he did better than the 2013 Republican candidate for governor, Ken Cuccinelli. He did better numerically than he did in 2014 when he almost won. In fact, Ed Gillespie got more votes than any Republican candidate for governor in the history of the Commonwealth of Virginia, ever. But ultimately, Democrat Ralph Northam shellacked him with the largest margin of victory for a Democrat in Virginia since 1985. And that was partly due to huge turnout in the suburbs for the Democrat. In Loudoun County, a suburban county right outside Washington, D.C., in 2014, Gillespie almost tied his Democratic opponent in that county. But this time, the Democrat took 60% of the vote, better than Hillary Clinton's share of the vote in 2016, and she won Virginia, better than the Democratic governor in 2013. Now, granted, it was a tough crowd for Gillespie, this state. One-third of the voters who showed up were at least partly motivated by voting against Donald Trump. But in addition to that, it seems as though what Gillespie did to rally his supporters successfully apparently also so turned off the suburban voters who had once been willing to listen to him, his fate was sealed.